What do you think?
She's a beauty, Dad, but a 47-footer?
You get to my age, you just don't piddle around.
Jeannie's not gonna like this.
Try smiling a lot.
You guys are going all the way, huh?
Dad's buying the boat. I'm just paying for the anchor.
If you need a crew, count me in.
You're in. 2 months. 2 months, then I'm off.
Well, that's what you said last year, and the year before.
And the year before, the year before.
Well, this time, and I told him so. I've got this incurable affection. It's called sea fever. Well, better get to work.
Chief?
Captain.
Morning, Chief.
Morning, Andrew.
Thank you.
Afterwards. I'll make you dinner.
Dinner? No, no, no. I don't eat dinner. You okay?
Yeah.
Listen, I'm sorry I gotta go now, but just close the door behind you when you leave, hmm?
Morning, Dr. Morris.
Good morning, Doctor.
Take it easy.
Sorry, Dr. Whitman.
Can I help you, please?
4 o'clock. Promptly.
Camera crew 3 to Studio A for color lineup.
Good morning, Miss Grayson.
Camera crew 3
morning,
to Studio A for color lineup.
Good morning, good morning, good
morning. Morning, Jimbo.
30 seconds.
Cigarette?
Sorry, forgot you quit. Listen, run this over with Freddie, will you?
Sure.
I've got to have a word with Lucretia Borgia.
Good luck.
Ah, good morning, Princess. Good morning.
That schmuck, Fulton. Didn't you find somebody better? Hey, what about that stuff on Diana Brockhurst? How good is it?
Oh, it's good. 3 minutes.
Sure?
Sure.
Uh-huh. Must be worth at least one good minute, eh?
arrival.
Yeah, they look okay to me.
This is Maggie Grayson. We'd like to welcome you.
Can you tell?
News and
no. Can't tell.
Our cameras were at the airport last night to greet a local celebrity. And Mayor Dudley and his charming wife were at the airport to welcome. But only recently would have from her second the European
Herman.
Publishing giant, David Lutton.
Herman! Herman, you're on television!
Diana's here for the dedication of the new hospital, built right smack in the derelict downtown part of our city.
Look, it's you. It's you.
Diana's our special sender.
What were you doing at the airport?
Our very own
you didn't tell me.
To riches, girl. I have nothing to say, except that I hope you'll all be there for the dedication ceremony tomorrow.
We all thank you, and we're proud that you're home.
The hospital is a memorial to her first husband, the late Governor Paul Brockhurst. She herself has endowed the hospital with a trust of $3 million, a generous gesture. Diana is now worth a modest $35 million. Welcome home, Diana. And now for the weather forecast.
35 million dollars. Oh, Herman, you did it.
I've got an important meeting this morning.
Don't forget your lunch.
Mr. Clark.
Who's Mr. Clark?
Just keep your fingers crossed.
Discussing the water shortage today is Maggie Grayson's guest.
I'll take care of the zoning board, but you'd better handle Carson yourself. And the flowers for Diana's room were delivered.
Turned down last night. The mayor's office issued a release indicating that the water reserves were slightly over 40%.
My information says that it is much lower than that.
Of course, you can't tell us where you got that information. Alderman, you've been wrong about Mayor Dudley before.
Go get him.
I'm appalled that Mayor Dudley...
That son of a bitch. He's starting his campaign for mayor. Now, why can't he wait until I'm governor? I could kick him in the ass.
Never get into a pissing contest with a skunk.
How'd he find out about the water?
Thanks.
Hey, give my regards to Diana. If I were 20 years younger, I'd fight you for her.
You'd lose. Just like the good old days, huh?
Champagne's the same.
What does that mean?
Edith looked good last night. You too. Every inch a governor. I mean, even I'd vote for you.
Diana.
I still love you.
Hello? Monsieur Pierre. Pas maintenant. Non, rappelez-moi demain à 3 heures. Non, votre heure. C'est bien ça. Au revoir.
As I was saying, I still love you. You remember Saint-Tropez?
This isn't Saint-Tropez.
I am still the same and you're still the same.
No, I'm not.
Oh, yeah.
No. Mmm.
They always have to have their finger in the pie.
Morning, Andrea.
Morning. We lost power in the West Wing for half an hour this morning.
What?
Yes.
The doctor will be with you in a moment, Mrs. Adams.
Mrs. Adams? You again?
Dr. Maswick.
This makes the third one in a little over 2 years? What's the matter, dear? Can't you remember and practice what the doctor taught you? Obviously not. Frank?
Yeah.
Would you believe our backup generator has only got half the juice we need? We're very lucky that this hospital isn't fully operational yet. Or would be in the up to here.
Dr. Myers, continue with the rounds, will you please?
Patients are reminded that visiting hours do not start until 1300 hours.
Oh, sorry. Oh, doctor, I'd like you to meet one of our new nurses, Miss Florence Stoddard, Dr. Whitman.
How do you do, doctor?
We've met. Nice to have you with us, Miss Stoddard.
This way, doctor, to the left.
Mr. Clark? Herman Stover.
Oh, yes. Of course. Come in, Stover. Stover, we have an opening in research. We'd like you to consider switching to that department.
Research?
Interesting opportunities in that branch, you know.
12 years in maintenance, they promised me I'd make foreman.
Your aptitude test shows that you'd serve the company better in research and development.
I belong in maintenance. I don't know anything about research. I'm in maintenance.
I take this to mean that you won't accept the transfer.
I want to be foreman.
The committee already decided on Kershaw.
Kershaw? I ain't working for Kershaw.
Very well. You get the usual severance pay and 1 week's vacation. You can present this to the paymaster. Stover.
You be late for lunch now.
I won't.
Come on, sweetheart.
Hey! What you guys doing?
Mrs. Bogdanovich, Debbie's in bed, but I'll be back as soon as I can.
Oh, if I hear the little one cry, I'll go right up.
Okay, thanks. Gerald, light up. Well, you got a drag on it, meathead.
Stand back, everybody. He's gonna up his cornflakes.
Debbie, make 6 photocopies of this. Send them out today.
Yes, sir.
What? I can't hear you, son.
My number is 720 Birchwood Avenue.
Oh, let's go.
My number is 720 Birchwood Avenue.
Okay, guys, get moving.
Getting the people out of those houses.
We might lose it.
Right away, sir.
Waller, keep it in touch with.
Yes, Captain.
Captain Risley here. Get me the chief, will you?
Captain Risley, reporting from Birchwood, chief.
What do we got, Harrison?
3 brick structures loaded with wood and a couple of old garages. Roof's starting to cook, too.
Can't hold it.
Andrew, where's Company 3?
They're, over at the new hospital for the dedication. What can I tell you? The mayor wanted a band.
Well, tell Company 3 to get their butts over to Birchwood now.
Yes, sir.
All right, Captain, your reinforcements are coming. The mayor wanted a band.
Test 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Master control, if you've got a picture. You know, we got a picture yet, John?
No, the power supply is screwed up.
Oh, Christ, come on, you guys, hurry up.
We'll be back in a moment.
Okay, guys, take 5. We're on a break.
This station joined the American...
Hey, Jimbo, we're getting a picture from Mobile One at the Birchwood Farm.
America's number one fitness personality and the new Jack LaLanne Show.
Maggie,
we've got a picture on Mobile One.
Now get back. Back. Come on, get back.
Debbie!
Now, okay, Debbie.
Oh, Debbie!
It's all right. Stay here.
Oh, my.
Come on.
God, Debbie!
Yes, someone in the house must
stay
now.
Everyone, that's my stay back. Girl.
Captain, there's a kid in the house.
Debbie.
Let's move.
What's that? We just learned that apparently there's a little girl inside the house. They're gonna try and find out what's going on here.
Debbie, where's Debbie?
I only went to the store for the carrots. Just to the store.
Come on, Debbie's up there.
What room is she in?
Second floor, back room.
Hey,
Gerald.
Hey.
Gerald! Oh.
Stand back.
No.
Keep the boys back, please.
Get back here, please.
Jim, go live with the remote. We'll intercut the spreading of the fire with the trap kid. Okay?
And as you can see, the flames are really becoming very, very strong. One of the firemen is still trapped inside. Oh, we see Captain Risley going back in right now with a couple other firemen. They're obviously trying to save their buddy, which is still inside that burning building. The flames going higher and higher all the time. The heat must be fantastic inside that burning building, and they've gone in to save their buddy.
Motor 11 and 406.
Get a pulse. I'm trying. You get a reading. It's unsteady. Your eyes are driving.
Guys, come on.
utilize your cameras. Look at it right now. So, of course, we'll be watching this fire very, very closely.
Commander, have units 4 and 11 stand by. Give me Captain Risley.
Right, Chief.
Good of you to come early, Mrs. Lautrec. It allows me to show you our beautiful hospital.
Hello, Mr. Lewis. How's Mrs. Lewis?
Fine.
Good.
Sir Henry.
Hello.
Mr. Sterling. His assistant,
hello.
Mr. Zakharov. This way, Mrs. Lautrec.
I got you, Diana, baby. Two-time loser Diana goes for number 3.
No. Does Mrs. Dudley know what Mayor Dudley do?
Diana and Mayor Dudley living it up. Heartbroken wife seeks divorce and custody of children.
Here, let me do that. Give me a vial of bicarbonate. Half cc and epinephrine. Try shock. Everybody, stand back. Notify Chief Frizzly. Enjoy the show, Diana?
Let's continue, Mr. Lewis.
No. Allow me. For $3 million, she's entitled to it.
International symbols, clever drawings by clever people, sign language, no words. Trouble is you need someone to tell you what the no words don't mean. You look older.
I am older.
Yeah, I guess jet-setting around, you know, marrying one guy, burying another. I'd look older, too.
Here, you're only good for bed and breakfast.
Well, sometimes they skip the breakfast. By the way, the story is that, I had to go to bed with you to get this job.
Really? Well, if we did go to bed, it couldn't have been terrific, because I don't remember it.
No, I think if I made a house call, I think you'd remember it all right.
Mm. Is it tough being accused of betting your way to the top?
Good morning.
Rakoff, the therapist. Dr. Rakoff, the therapist.
I love Paul, I love David.
Yeah.
I did. I loved all the men I went to bed with.
Well, how many were there?
How many with you?
Well, no, 200, 300. No, I had a bicycle.
Still fast. I paid $3 million for this walk, but could we get it over with?
Doctor, how's my sister?
Oh, Joe, I think she's got a very good chance. Is your father coming to get you?
You sure my sister will be all right?
You bet she will be.
Oh, she's pretty, isn't she?
Mrs. Bogdanovich brought it for Debbie. The birds aren't allowed here.
Oh. Well, you better hide her over there.
Dr. Watson.
We went to the same school. Same lousy neighborhood. The pits. Diana Brockhurst Lutre. And me. She started the year I graduated. Every senior at Sycamore High was in love with her. And she goes and marries some guy 30 years older. Governor. 30 years older.
Here.
Nobody listens.
It's okay, Herman. I'll go mop over there.
Yeah, why don't you do that? Then she goes and marries another old man. But you're gonna listen.
What's wrong with the stacks?
Christ, we're building up a lot of pressure.
Thank you.
But you have
staff
to...
are reminded
Diana.
That a short dedication ceremony...
Dr. Whitman?
...at noon today.
Johnny?
At the Prince...
I was beginning to think you were avoiding me.
No, I'd never forget you, Diana. And I'd never very far, believe me. I hope you'll change your mind and join us in the speaker's platform, Dr. Whitman.
No, I don't think so, really.
It would look better, you know, the head of a new hospital.
Well, it may look better, but I don't think it would sound better. I don't think you'd like what you'd be hearing.
But what's eating you now? You have a new job, and the city has a beautiful new hospital.
That's right, some new hospital. You know, it looks real good on the outside. But thanks to your political favors here and there. See, I'm stuck with the patch-up job.
Well, nothing is perfect. Everything is compromised. Now, if you're the mayor of a big city and you want to get things done, you have to learn to give and take.
Try talking to a surgeon about compromise during an open heart operation, huh?
Dr. Whitman. When I call on you, I expect you to come up and speak.
Is that a challenge?
If you'd like to put it that way.
Will you just do that, Mr. Mayor? I look forward to it.
Listen, boss, we're in a hell of a mess here. The steam power's broken.
Publishing us.
That's right.
Does that mean there's a new man behind you?
None that I can see.
You gonna get married again, Diana?
Well, if I do, you'll be the first to know.
John, where's the band?
Well, there's a big fire going on. We can't.
For Christ's sake. Hello, fellas.
Hi, George.
Bob, good to see you.
Mr. Mayor, can I have a word with you, please?
No. A little later, okay?
Okay, remotes 4, 5, and 6, stand by for the pickup of the dedication. After Mrs. Latrec, we're gonna cut back to Birchwood.
Make up. Hey.
...350 degrees, and all that protects your engine is a layer of oil this thin.
You look gorgeous, Princess.
Gorgeous. Okay, stand by one, stand by Maggie.
Shell supermotograde.
Outfit of Maggie.
And now to the dedication ceremonies of our new hospital, where Mayor Dudley and Diana Brockhurst-Lautrec are the guests of honor.
You look very chic, sir.
I'll take it.
Okay, we can go again.
Devoted to life, as he was devoted to life and to people, would please him enormously. He loved the city and was proud of its success, particularly the last 10 years. And so it's with great joy that I present the check for $3 million
to the chairman of the board of directors.
Birchwood is a control situation.
I repeat, Birchwood is under control.
Harrison.
Yes, Chief.
Harrison, Joe Waller didn't make it. I'll go see his wife myself. Did a good job at Birchwood, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
I'd like to introduce to you now the new head of the Brockhurst Hospital. It was not an easy choice. It was quite difficult.
Well, see you. Have a good day.
You too.
Well, let's get this thing in the road.
Yeah, shifter.
Thank you.
Doctors, nurses, help everyone who was hurt inside, please.
Lift him
now,
up.
Everyone out here.
All right.
Please do not
put you,
panic.
Put you
do not
on my shoulder. That's
we'll help you in a moment.
Come on. Okay. Just relax, okay?
Switch over to emergency power immediately. Harper, have all staff report to me as soon as possible. Now clear out that receiving area. Clear it out.
Over 60 fires have shot it already. I haven't been able to reach the mayor to get a code 9, so I'm assuming Command Mike. Radio the governor to mobilize the National Guard.
Yes, Chief.
Johnson, contact Temple County. Ask the National Park Service for the tanker planes.
Yes, sir.
Martin, call the Parker Field for some additional choppers.
Yes, sir. What are you waiting for?
Everyone, and I mean everyone, is subject to immediate recall.
Stella?
Yes, sir.
I want to talk to both Police Chief Abrams and Councilman Haley.
This is really it. Just imagine, Jimbo. Every station on the network and they want me.
You gonna do it without cameras, Maggie?
Oh, is that the best you can do?
I'm sorry, Miss Grayson. All the roads are blocked. I had to fish into Wardville for these.
Listen, what about that Birchwood group?
Already taking care of that.
My goddamn mess.
Darling, do sit still.
What about the crew from the dedication ceremony?
Yeah, we can use him.
Good. Put him on the roof.
The roof?
Yes.
Becky, you're a genius.
I know. Oh, can't you do something about these lines?
Meg, darling, only God can perform miracles.
Out. Both of you! The hell out of here.
Turn all monitors, Jimbo. Standby cards ready.
All right, stand by to cue Maggie. Stand by one, stand by Maggie. On fire, and that turkey picks now to get loaded.
10 seconds. 9, 8.
7, 6.
This is Maggie Grayson reporting. At 12:37, the Manson refinery, the ninth largest in the world, erupted with devastating force. The cause is as yet unknown. The massive refinery, built against public protest, covered some 300 acres and has a supposed storage capacity of 15 million gallons. The initial casualty reports are staggering, and fires are raging out of control all over our city. The multiple explosions have created havoc and total destruction of a large part of the city.
Started. Ring his lactate. Put him on 100% oxygen. That one, urinary catheter and NG2. Now move.
Dr. Brass. Dr. Brass to
Hi, Jim. Yeah. I'm a hell of a mess in this one, Johnny. I pushed for that refinery.
Yeah. That's the risk of politics. Yesterday, you're a hero, and today, you're a fool. For exactly the same reason.
Come on. I don't know what the hell to do. Can't get through on the phone to Risley or Abrams or anybody.
No, it's bad. But you can turn it around, make it good.
God damn it, Johnny. Don't humor me. Don't know how to deal with this one. On top of it all, you picked today to go ahead and get a heart attack.
Hey. Never admit that you were wrong about the refinery.
Now, don't you go dying on me, for Christ's sake. Come on.
You'll be governor. You'll do it. Bet you $7 you'll do it, kid.
Huh? Welcome to home. Dr. Corn.
Doctor, I'm looking for my sister.
Dr. Blanc.
The
ID
is empty.
Hmm? You'll need
D5W. Dr. Whitman, will you look at this, please?
Look, you're just prepping for OR.
What's this offer?
I want everybody out of the hospital. Everybody, except patients and doctors. That means all visitors, administrative staff, security guards, everybody out. You try the Prince Street exit. That'll still be safe. I want you to do it right now. We still need all the room we can for the sick ones, okay?
Oh, my God. We need oxygen! Can't.
You know how to work that thing?
I'll figure it out.
I hope so, because I don't think I can do that again. Come on, hurry
okay.
up.
Okay.
Doctor.
Doctor, what?
Please, my son.
Okay, come on, son.
Now, we have to find him a room.
There aren't any.
Well, we'll find some.
Easy, we're gonna put you down right over here, okay?
Nurse,
come on, all visitors out of the hospital.
Please.
No, I mean now. Come on. Now.
Sorry, lady, we need this room.
Hey, you can't take me out of here. Look at it,
I'm
a baby.
A baby born in a corridor is illegitimate.
I don't like it, Sam. Those fires look awful close to me, and they're getting closer.
Well, just think of your pension.
I am thinking about it. I'm thinking about how I want to lift the collectors.
Man, will you get to work?
The casualties are now close to 3,000. To complicate matters, water pressure has fallen considerably. Despite the help of neighboring communities, the scattered locations of fires...
Does it show? Can you tell me?
...are more than the combined firefighters.
No, you can't.
Now... As night approaches, looting has begun.
No, you can't tell. Bring him in from the client. Hell, you can't. Jesus!
It's almost more than the National Guard and the police can cope with.
Come on, John. Relax. Have a cigarette.
Wish the hell it'd start smoking again. Get off my thighs. Zoom in on that, please.
Look, I just want to get in there.
No,
I'm not a looter. I just want to get some
where the picking men. You got the pictures?
No,
I can't be alone.
I'm trying. Go, Terry.
Alvin.
It'll be okay.
He's in real bad shape.
Seven fires have already been reported out of control. Here, here, and here. We have little chance of preventing total destruction. I recommend we evacuate the areas immediately. Prepare for demolition. Prevent the fires from spreading any further.
Chief Risley, I do think we should first confer with Mayor Dudley.
Constable, when you can contact him, you'll confer. In the meantime, I'll take the responsibility. Andrew, what's the latest forecast?
Hot, dry weather with northeasterly winds increasing 20 to 30 miles an hour.
Gentlemen, gather around. Take a look. Here's the hospital. Only the area to the south of the hospital is unthreatened so far.
My God, the hospital's gonna burn. We just built the damn thing.
My biggest concern at the moment is the danger of a firestorm.
A what?
If the fire surrounds the hospital, it'll burn up the oxygen. The people suffocate. We've got to find a way to communicate with the hospital.
Chief, the TV high-angle shots were taken from the roof of the Paul Brockhurst Hospital. Maybe there's a way to talk to those guys up there.
What are you waiting for? Get in touch with the station.
Yes, sir.
Anybody out
there? I'm here, nurse.
Nurse Collingwood, to X-ray. Nurse Collingwood, to X-ray.
Yeah. We understand, Tuba. You can count on us. Thanks, Jimbo. We're doing our best. Yeah.
Fire's getting closer.
Get going, you heard the man.
Patients are requested to board the vehicles outside in an orderly fashion. There is no cause for alarm.
Can I help with that?
No, I don't need any help. I didn't go to medical school for 3 years.
What medical school taught you to do this? All right, hero, listen. Why don't you help them get all those people into the trucks, huh? Come on, come on.
Have you had babies before?
Ah, sure, too.
Oh, well, do you think you have to have this one right now?
For you, maybe another half an hour.
Oh, good girl.
Oh. Okay, let's be taken. Move along.
Spotter,
ready.
There is no cause for alarm.
Right.
Personnel will be traveling with...
Anybody else?
Oh. Look, come on. Come on, keep moving.
You mind telling me what's going on out here with the ambulances?
Not a bit, Mr. Mayor. You know, it seems that there was some idiot who let them build a refinery right in the middle of the city, and this is the result. You know, I bet it was you. I really would like to hear you talk yourself out of this boo-boo.
Do you mind telling me what's going on out here?
Doctor's orders. Dr. Whitman wants the rest of the hospital evacuated in a hurry. You know, you could do both of us a favor, Mr. Mayor. Get yourself in one of those trucks. At least this will keep you out of the governor's mansion.
Don't take any bets on it.
Well, I ain't gonna vote for you!
Listen, we're all gonna play a little game now, okay? Now, you all know how to play follow the leader, okay?
Yeah. Yeah. I know how.
Now, if you don't do what I tell you to do, I'll take all your tonsils out. You understand?
I don't want my tonsils out.
Okay, everybody, come on. Get in line now. We're gonna get ready. Come on, kids. Just start to help them out, will you please?
No.
Here we go. Okay? Now, remember, you gotta do everything that I do. Here she comes. Ready? George, I'll come back for you, okay? Just thought I'd look after him. Here we go. Follow the leader. Boom, 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 boom,
Go away, little girl.
What on earth is the matter with you, you silly old man?
Miss!
What? All right, we'll do something about that.
Diana!
Aha, Bill. Just the one I need. Well, don't stand there. Come on, help me. Get him up. Wait a minute. Whoops. Cut. Better now?
I'm going back down to City Hall. I want you to come with me.
Through all this?
We can make it now. We may not be able to a little later.
I can't. I can't.
Diana, now listen to me. Johnny died.
I'm ready.
Now you tell me.
Maggie, you have got to get back up there. Listen, we just got the go-ahead from the network. We're going national. National! With you as liaison between Dudley and Risley. Yes, you can, Maggie. Maggie, you can, sweetheart.
Yeah, listen. Hey, maybe if I had some.
No. This you're gonna have to do without that. No.
You put on the dress. You do it. You'd be absolutely great. You want to, don't you?
Maggie, listen. Do you trust me?
Yes, darling. Oh, yeah, like a snake. Oh, I trust you.
Haven't I always taken care of you? Seen you through every show.
My darling, yes.
Made sure that you came across intelligent, bright, beautiful.
Oh, yes.
And that's just how you're going to be this time, sweetheart.
But you see, I am.
You're going to be bright, intelligent, and you're going to be beautiful. I promise you, she's going to be just wonderful, man.
You rotten son of a bitch!
No, it's all right now. You just need a little freshening up.
I'll have you fired with this, you rotten bastard.
You get some more of that on your face. That's wonderful. Just stay like that. Now I'm going to bring in the wrecking crew.
I will. I'll get even with you. I will.
I love you too, sweetheart.
You rotten.
I'll see you on the set. 10 minutes.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe so.
Fixer.
Thank you.
That woman on the third bed is bleeding from the nose. Mop her up a bit, will you?
I need something for pain.
All right. Did you ever give her an injection?
That'd be ridiculous. Of course not.
All right. You put it in her shoulder, throw in the air, and you just pretend it's an arm. Come on, you can do it.
Get an IV ready. There could be a perforated ulcer. See if there's any blood in the bank.
What's taking so long?
Okay, go to Bill then. Go to Bill, Garrett.
Where's the sound?
Mayor Dudley, can you hear me?
Yes, Miss Grayson. I hear you very well.
Let's try to patch in the chief.
Hey, Marty. Looks like Jimbo's starting a weekend.
He's smoking.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's smoking.
There, he did it. I'll be damned.
Chief Risley.
Go ahead, Chief.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear her, Chief?
Can you not hear me, Chief Risley?
Yes, I do, Miss Grayson. I apologize. But we have no time for formalities. Mayor Dudley, are you having difficulty breathing?
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, I am.
Mr. Mayor, I'm afraid the hospital may be caught in a firestorm.
Chief Risley, does that mean that the people in the hospital are in danger of suffocating?
Mayor Dudley, it's very important that everyone in the hospital get out of the area as quickly as possible.
There's a dog up there. I can't imagine how he got there, but it doesn't look like he has much hope. The building is about to collapse. It's going to go any minute.
It's changing so drastically, it's impossible.
The units remain off the air, sir.
However, we can try something else. Get my son on the radio.
Company 27 to the Prince Street exit of the Rockhurst Hospital. Repeat. Company 27 to the Prince Street exit of the Rockhurst Hospital.
We're about a mile south, proceeding directly.
Harrison, to get those people out of the hospital, we're going to need a water tunnel.
Roger. I'll report on arrival. We'll need backup and paramedics.
You okay?
Yes, thanks. But I'm worried.
talk to Whitman, says there's no more oxygen even for Debbie.
Well, we can't use oxygen with the fire all around us.
Give her some of this, just...
Not too much, just a few drops at a time.
Terry James.
Oh, the photographer.
The one you had arrested.
Don't move too much. You're losing strength.
It's all right. I've got the pictures.
What?
I know you. The camera. I'm going to do your life in pictures.
That's terrific.
I see you, everything about you. They're going to know you, Diana. You buy pictures.
Diana, I guess you don't remember high school.
Miss Latrec, can you help me, please?
High school?
Yeah, you started the year I graduated. Listen.
Get it, buddy. Quick.
You can't stay out here. There's no air.
Call that door, lady. The fire is there.
Come on. We can't call yet.
I can't stand it anymore.
Oh, God.
Dudley needs to cover the first 100 yards from his end.
Can you find out if there are any hoses at the hospital?
Mayor Dudley, the first 100 yards has to be covered from your end. Are there enough hoses at the hospital?
I don't know. I'm going to check on it. Get me an emergency lamp.
Switch into manual oxygen.
Right here.
Whitman. Whitman. Chief,
get out of here.
Now, this is urgent.
I said get out of here.
Saying, Mr. Mayor. You're a patient, Doctor.
Okay, let's stitch you up.
That's fine, I can take over.
Did you?
Know where the fire hose stations are in the hospital and the water supply hookups? Do you know where they are?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, good. Show them to me, will you, please?
You really have a doctor. Look at that leg.
Doctor, after what I just saw, I think I'll pass on that.
Franks, get Mason to come with me.
Adams, you can't. Not now.
Could I lie at a time like this?
Well, you gotta hold it until I find someone.
It's not up to me anymore. Oh, okay.
You have to tell me what to do. You have a lot more experience than I have.
Don't worry, you'll do fine. I'll help you.
Thank you.
That's all there is!
All right!
We'll have to let them down, and they can make a run for it.
He's gonna soak you all with water. He's gonna follow you as far as he can. Got it? Then the fireman will cover you the rest of the way until you reach safety. All right, let's start with them.
Carol, leave him there.
No!
Leave her. I'll take care of her. Mason, get a sheet and get him out of here. Okay. All right, you can go next. Yeah, take this with you. Fine. What's the matter with him? All right, all right. Hold it, hold it. All right, hold on. All right, hold it. Hold it, hold it. All right.
Wait, it's very important for you and me.
Get out of here! I see something. What do I do? Give me your hands. Give me your hands.
Okay, move on. Here we go!
Run! Hey, hey! Okay. All right, move on!
paramedics for attention. Right.
Medic!
Let's move along quickly and orderly, but move. Everybody, let's move along. Come on back here, let's go. Bring him along. Move it along. That's it. Now, everybody's going to get wet down on here, so remember, they're going to soak you down completely. Soak, everybody. Get those grips. Go ahead. Go.
Congratulations. Not bad.
Hey, you are terrific. You were better.
We better get going. We still have time to get you out with the last group.
Hold it, hold it. Hold it, steady. Get your weapon.
said right or good and west. All right, go on. Go on, go. Quickly.
Keep covered up.
All right, stay there. That's a good and west here. All right, go on, go on. Go on.
You okay? Baby round
up. You got a date.
Move on. Stretch him a minute. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it.
Why the hell didn't you go with him?
Thank you.
Hey, there's the dog. Let's go, Doc. Hey,
anything about Jeannie and the kids?
Yes, they're okay.
See you later, Dad.
Take care.
How does it feel to be a hero?
Hero? Well, the real heroes of this tragedy are the people of this fair city.
You know, this won't work.
Of course it won't.
Maggie, you were terrific.
Wasn't I? And now can I have that drink?
Come on. I'm buying. You should have seen the last close-up here when we were talking to Dan. Yeah. Low angle, the lighting was fantastic. You look beautiful.
Did I?
Yeah. God.
All it takes is one man. Could be anybody. Your neighbor, my neighbor. One man to destroy a city.